You're listening to In the Moment on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. I'm Lori Walsh. The Sioux Falls Levitt at the Falls concert series is underway Thursdays through Fridays, I think maybe Saturdays. And Saturdays, yep, people have the opportunity to come by the Levitt Shell, hang out on the lawn for a summer of free music. Well, this Saturday, Eric Holm is going to open, and he is from Brookings, South Dakota. He is a frequent guest and friend of the show, although we were just discussing we haven't seen each other since it was difficult to breathe in the same room as other people. So this is our first post-COVID moment in sound with teacher Eric, who also does children's workshops and children's music, and then this radical queer country music that you do that you'll be kind of playing at the Levitt this weekend. How have you been, friend?
Hi, Lori. I'm doing all right. Yeah, I'm so glad to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah.
And I'm doing okay, yeah.
You're
we haven't seen each other since before COVID started, which also my dad died right around then, and I know he was on the show all the time, every week or something.
Your dad died right around the time my brother died.
Right.
So we were going through a lot together emotionally at that time.
Yeah.
Love your dad. Miss him.
Yeah.
Father's Day is always a challenge for those of us who don't have dads with us anymore. So go hug your dad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. Go out there. Yeah.
You're living in Houston now.
I'm living in Houston now. I'm from Brookings.
Yeah.
And I get to play here in South Dakota on Father's Day weekend. It's also Pride, you know.
Yeah.
And last week was Brookings Pride, and this week is Sioux Falls Pride. And, the part of the reason I'm singing at the Levitt has to do with Pride. So it's kind of this special emotional time. When I was a kid in South Dakota, I don't feel like there was no such thing, right?
Right.
So a lot has changed, and a lot is changing now. You know, Dad's not here, but he is. Right?
Right,
that's a part of the.
My brother used to
magic.
Say, like the first. He was from Sioux Falls. We were from Sioux Falls, and he said the first Pride they had, you know, laughingly, he said, was like two of his friends walking up and down Phillips Avenue with their dog, and then they sat on the curb and cheered.
Woo!
Boy, a lot's changed since then.
Yeah.
What do you want to sing for us first?
I have a song I wrote, sort of about growing up in South Dakota. It's called "Queer Kids in Red States." I'll probably sing it tomorrow night at the Levitt. And it's on my debut record, which is a self-titled album called Eric Holm. I'd love you to listen to it if you've never heard it. It's called Queer Kids in Red States. She was 6 or 7, wanna watch the dancing on TV. She knew her mom didn't like Ellen, but dancing something she wanted to see, but dancing was something she had to see. The summer he turned 13, the minute his folks would walk out the door, he'd cuddle his dog, wear his mom's red shoes, and say, "We're not in Kansas anymore. We're not in Kansas anymore." May feel alone, but I swear it's not the case. You can make it through. I'm talking to you, queer kids in red states. Coming to end their senior year, they weren't a girl, they weren't a boy, to learn of a thing called gender queer. Well, it spiked their senior year with joy. It filled their queer little heart with joy. Won't you listen to Uncle Dan? It can get better, I know that it can. Don't you quit, you can make it right if you learn to breathe, or learn to leave, or learn how to stay and fight. He came out at 70, retiring from the university, you know. He didn't know what would come to be, but I'd never seen him so young and free. I'd never seen him so young and free. You may feel alone, but I swear it's not the case. You can make I'm talking to you, queer kids in red states. I'm talking to you, queer kids in red states.
Eric Holm is here with us live in the SDPB Sioux Falls studio. He's playing the Levitt Shell this Saturday. It's all part of a pretty extensive Pride weekend here in the city of Sioux Falls. There are Pride weekends and events in other communities across the state, so you can check those out. What would a song like that have meant to you as a younger, you're pretty young now, but like, you know, as I don't know what grade, fifth grade.
Yeah. Well, I didn't come out to myself even.
Okay.
As a bisexual person, as a queer person, which, you know, queer is like the umbrella term, right? And bisexual is one of the things until, you know, till I was in college. I was a freshman in college, and I read a book, and there was a bisexual character, and he was in love with women, but he was also finding himself falling in love with his friend and his guy friend, his gay friend. And I felt a horrifying thrill of recognition. And
yeah.
I think that if there had been music like this, I might have felt like I could be myself sooner, you know. Hmm. My partner is non-binary. They use they/them pronouns. They're like the character in the song, not a boy, not a girl. And when we were young, we didn't even really have terms like non-binary.
Right.
Or genderqueer or gender fluid. And so this language is really empowering. It lets us kind of claim ourselves.
Our fullness,
yeah.
You have another song you're going to play for us, and this is pretty special because I have not heard it yet.
Yes.
That's not why it's special, but it's, I'm also excited.
It's brand new. I actually released it this morning. It's on the internet now. It's on my Bandcamp. If you look at ericholmmusic.bandcamp.
Holm is H-O-L-M, by
right.
the way, in case
Eric
you know.
With a C.
Yep.
And I'm not going to release it for another month or so, or maybe longer, on the big streaming services.
Sure.
I'm directing people that you can
Bandcamp.
Put some dollars in the musician's hat. I'm traveling traveling back to Texas shortly. That would be great, and I'd be honored to have your ears on it. And the third song on the little EP, it's an EP called The Good Doctor EP. Mm. I made it with my brother Preston and his collaborator Kyle, and it's called They Are a Scientist. The joke is, we're lately been saying, it may be the greatest non-binary love song in the world.
All right. Take a listen, Eric Holm.
They are the sweetest ones. My darling one, they've got a heart for each biome. They are a scientist, planet activist. They're fighting for our blue-green home. Blue green home. They've got a case to make, got a system to break. I'm gonna hold their hand so tight, and honey, when they're spent. When that letter is sent, we're gonna spoon and nest at night. Oh, spoon and nest at night. And honey, when scared, feeling underprepared, like when we face another storm, They've got a love in me. We've got a sunrise to see. We're gonna keep us safe and warm. May we all be safe and warm. They are a scientist and a Zen Buddhist. They've got a heart for each biome.
Eric Holm joining us today for Moment in Sound. I can feel your dad in the room with both of us right now with that song and how beautifully you played it. Playing at the Levitt this weekend. The lawn opens at 6:30. You're the opening act, so get there at 6:30 and be ready to support the opening acts, who are often folks that we know and love from our own home communities. So Bandcamp, address again?
It's ericholmmusic.bandcamp.com. The new album is called The Good Doctor EP. It's three original songs.
The Good Doctor EP. We appreciate you coming by today.
Thank you so much for having me.
And playing for us and this weekend and everything for all that you'll do over the weekend. We're going to take you out with a recorded song from Eric Holm and say thanks to Megan Feary from SDPB for helping us today for the production from Carl Norquist and Chris Loughery. I'm Lori Walsh. Thanks for listening.